are. Everybody out there doing good? Welcome to another worldwide webcast. This week's theme is backstory. And, you know, I've never done themes, I've just done these shows. So
is it in a good position?
We'll see how this one works out. I've got, you know, some visual aids and whatnot. I hope everybody's doing okay out there. I know most of you are in some area of the world where it's really hot and probably humid too. Although, since it's a worldwide webcast, maybe our friends in Australia are having a different season or something. We hope they're tuned in. This whole thing will live later on YouTube
and
Webb TV.
I'll let you go. Text me if you need me.
And Madam X is doing some production stuff in the background. I couldn't do this without her. But yeah, the other shows that I've done, I think this is the sixth one maybe, are on Webb TV. And I went in there and tried to answer the comments and put the set lists and all that stuff. So, you know, if you don't hear one of your favorite songs tonight, it's probably on one of those other shows on YouTube. And so tonight I'm going to do a lot of songs that you don't normally hear me do, and a couple or three that maybe you do. I've played to some pretty stone-faced crowds before that needed to, you know, have a ringer song. And I'm not saying you guys are stone-faced, but I thought I'd start off with something that Wildarians seem to like, particularly since it's hot weather. And if you've got a swimming pool, and, you know, you're in kind of lockdown or whatever, you're probably making good use of it. It's a song. The backstory on this, you know, this is on my first album, or our first album. It came from Nashville. This particular copy, Landslide Records has been great to me, but this is pre-Landslide. This is Racket Records, and that was our own label that got Landslide's attention. So there were only 1,500 of these. And the vinyl is not currently in print on either label. We have the CDs with an expanded track listing, but this is the original thing. So this song, Poolside, was written by our friends Wally Wilson, Kevin Welch, and John Hadley, who I later wrote some songs with. And they were big fans, and they brought us the song, and we were a little skeptical because we thought, you know, some other guys gave us some songs that we didn't want to cut. But we were impressed with this one, and we've been doing it ever since. So it goes back to, what, 86 or something it's called? Poolside. I got a nice apartment, got a window with a view. I get up every morning and I go down to the pool. Everybody's pretty, everybody's nice. Everybody's got a little something on ice. I never go swimming, cause that ain't cool. But every day you're gonna find me hanging around the pool. Poolside, baby. Laying in the sun with my dark sunglasses.
Side, well, honey, I'll be poolside if you're looking for me.
apologies to my canine friends. It's just a swimming pool thing, guys. Amara. Okay, that was fun. It's good to be doing this, you know. When you're out there doing the honky-tonks, you kind of keep a bit of an edge, not compared to, you know, you super pickers or, you know, your Frank Sinatras, your Presleys and stuff. But old Webb, you know, has a little bit of a edge when he's a little more frequently performing. So we've been doing these kind of monthly. And so we'll probably, you know, we'll probably do another one no later than a month from now. And, you know, with any luck, we'll have some exciting news, you know. Maybe I'll become a 35 or 40-year-old overnight sensation, and I can tell you all about it. I told you you'd probably hear me do some songs you don't normally hear me do. There are a lot of songs that, have loved for years and sat around and played and never performed in public, and this is probably one of them. This is Harry by Harry Nilsson. In my humble opinion, this is the very best Nilsson album, and sadly, it is a little underappreciated because it has more subtlety than Nilsson Schmilsson and a little Schmilsson in the Night, and it's not a concept album like The Point, and all of those are great, and Nilsson was such a great singer that he could blow your mind with his singing. For instance, like he covered the Badfinger song, you know, Without You, and people go gaga over that because it's a tour de force vocally, but it's kind of the Carpenters for me, you know. I like the Badfinger version. Don't get me started on Badfinger. If I could hit those notes, I'd sing some Badfinger songs. So anyway, this album, though, to me is killer. This is about the time when the Beatles were asked, who's your favorite American group, and they said Nilsson. This particular song, I think this is 68 or so, is called Maybe, and it's one I've always loved on the album, and it goes like this. Maybe you wouldn't be leaving if only I'd change. You say I'm acting just like a kid. Well, maybe I'm doing what I'm doing. I've done what I did when I was a kid now. Documentary on the fascinating and sometimes tragic life of Harry Nilsson. His life kind of had a happy ending, except his his Jimmy Rogers sort of rambling ways early in his life shortened the life in the end, but he had some sober, happy, familial times in between. So, you know, thanks for indulging me by putting up with old Harry Nilsson by way of Webb Wilder. Some of you may know that I'm a big Dave Edmunds fan, and always have been, and my default setting for rhythm guitar is, which Dave has called at one time or another, the monkey beat, the rat-a-racka. The only fortunate thing is, since I'm such a lousy copier of people's styles, mine kind of comes out inside out to Dave's. So I've got all his albums. This album is one of many great ones. It's called Tracks on Wax 4. And, you know, these albums are basically Rock Pile albums, but they had contractual reasons. The Rock Pile poster's behind me, that they couldn't record them under the name Rock Pile. So Nick Lowe's on here, Billy Bremner, Terry Williams. The song I'm going to play you is credited writing-wise to Nick Lowe / Rockpile. So, you know, Nick is such a songwriter, and he probably kind of wrote it with the guys in the band. It's best done in harmony. It's kind of an Everly Brothers-ish thing, and I did it. I've never done it in public except one time, and I did it with Tom Comet. Tom, if you're watching, howdy, brother. We did it on a duo gig, and it was a lot of fun, but I just kind of can't not do it, so Never Been in Love. I'm going to try it.
You ought to see the way my friends stare whenever we're out anywhere. They make a scene, they cause a fuss, such a commotion all over us. But they all want to know why we're all aglow. They can't understand why we're walking hand in hand, because they've never been in love. Don't ever mind what's on the grapevine, because I am yours and you are mine. They think it's rich when I call you honey. They get upset, but I just think it's funny. Let them have them say, we can walk away. They'll never understand, they'll never know the way it feels, cause they've never been in love. I don't mind when I hear whispers, words ain't sticks and stones. They can't break our love plated bones. Gonna quit now, we're gonna cry just a little bit. They're gonna try to put us both down, but don't you worry, you're not alone. Let them go ahead, they've already said they don't understand being one as we two can, cause they've never been in love. No, they've never been in love. No, they've never been in love. Sticks and stones, they can't break our love-plated bones. There may be times you wanna quit now, we're gonna cry just a little bit. They're gonna try to put us both down, but don't you worry, you're not alone. They've already said they don't understand, they don't understand being one as we two can, cause they've never been.
What can I say? You know. Come on. I have some documents here that I have no provenance. I can't prove it, but I think they were handwritten by Webb Wilder. Their eBay value, inestimable. Inestimable, I'm sure. You're listening to WEBB. You know, I do that weekly radio show on, WMOT. And I just tossed away my set list. But tonight it's WEBB. All right, then. What have I got next? I know what I got next. Man, I hope everybody's okay out there. It's a crazy time. It's, without a doubt, the weirdest time I've ever lived through. But we're going to make it. We're going to get it. We're going to get there. And you know, that's the tipping thing. I've done these shows, some of you tipped me. I'm very grateful. I'm humbly grateful. But if you don't have the dough, as many of us don't right now, I get it. It's free show, folks. But yeah, it's just paypal.me/worldofwilder. I don't know why we made it that complicated, but we did. Moving right along with our theme, backstory. I'm having a good time. I hope y'all are. You know, I'm just staring at this backside of a cell phone. But let's see. Yeah, this guy used to blow my mind. You know, I was born and raised in Mississippi, and I left there a few times before I left for good, even though I treasure my Mississippi roots. And I used to see him play live at the old Exit Inn, where we would later record when it had a completely different personality. Jonathan Edwards. He had a hit with a song called Sunshine years ago. Well, I used to go see him play. Sometimes it was just him and a bass player. Sometimes it was maybe his wife on a 12-string. All acoustic except for the bass. Phenomenal. And I was at the 30A Songwriter Festival a few years ago listening to someone else play. And there was some guy to my right. And I realized later it was him. And I didn't recognize him. I wish I had a... He and I both changed. Anyway, you know, I wish I'd said something to him. Apparently, there was some character who went under the moniker of the legendary Stardust Cowboy. And I did a little research on him today. And his real name, I think, was Norman Carl Odom from Lubbock, Texas. Don't know much about him. So I don't know if that inspired the song Jonathan Edwards did on this album, the Honky Tonk Stardust Cowboy. But I've always loved this song. And apparently it was written not by Jonathan Edwards, but by a guy named Daryl Statler. I kind of relate to the guy in the song, you know what I'm saying? With his cowboy boots and rhinestone suits, a flashy guitar, he makes the rounds of the bars in town, trying to be a hillbilly star. You play all night if you treat him right, then buy him a beer or two. That the honky-tonk Stardust Cowboy sings for you. He sings the country tunes of bygone days, faded love, saddened on the road, and I love you a thousand ways. No matter what you request, he'll sing it loud and do his best, so that the honky-tonk Stardust Cowboy keeps on singing. Sometimes in his mind a dream unwinds, and he's called to fame. Brighter lights shine in his eyes as he's up there on the Opry stage. But life goes on, so you'll find him home to the dream that turned out wrong. Still the honky-tonk Stardust Cowboy sings a song. He sings the country tunes of bygone days, faded love, Stardust Cowboy. It seems like the learned roots music scribe Peter Guralnick wrote about the Stardust, legendary Stardust Cowboy somewhere, but I don't know. I'm maybe talking out my hat. At any rate, so you know, I grew up on the Top 40 and the country music television programs and the British Invasion and all that stuff, and then disco came along. It didn't really please me. Although when you hear the old disco records now, real people, playing real instruments, no drum machines. It's kind of cool. But the advent of disco and sort of a down period in rock as we knew it gave rise to what we called then the progressive country movement. So, you know, I mean, I took my first trip to New York in a cowboy hat and Nakona cowboy boots. And about that time, I discovered this, that was around 1974, I discovered this album, which came out in 73. Jerry Jeff Walker can get his persona around a song of the ilk I'm about to play you better than anyone. This thing was live. It was a classic, you know. It was done in Luckenbach, Texas, 73. Or it came out in 73, it was recorded in 73, I think. This particular song, I think I used to sing with my friends in the Peabody College men's dorm while we drank Stroh's beer. And I always liked it. It was written by Michael Martin Murphy, believe it or not, who can actually write a good song, you know, and all that, and loves the cowboy thing. But when you hear Jerry Jeff do it, it's got a particular Falstaffian quality, if you will. It's called Backslider's Wine. As the rain ruins my alibi, I'm down to telling you my red-eyed mind. It's not the sun bright path that led me from my home. It's that fight for your rights, but don't just fight for right, and do not drink backslider's wine. But I took myself to be a pure and loving soul till I found my faith. He had a lot of years under his belt at that point. He's still really good, though. Really good. Jackie Jack. Oh, yeah. I'm going to change guitars. I'm going to make my debut playing in open G tuning. I've never done that in public. But since I'm in my basement here, you know. Again, I hope you're doing good. Oh, yeah. Thank y'all for everything. Thanks for those of you who bought the new album, Night Without Love. We'll get to that more in a minute. Let's see. All right, I tuned this sucker to open G flat, which is F sharp. okay, here's the thing, you know, it's cool to discover music not by the original artist, as long as you go back and check it out by the original artist. Or even if you don't, if you just enjoy it, you enjoy it, right? But I mean, I think a lot of us did that, you know, like the Stones turned us on to the real Chuck Berry records and stuff like that, you know, or the real Muddy Waters records or whatever. So this guy, known by many as the Welsh Elvis, Shakin' Stevens, made some great records. I don't know about all his records, but I know this is great. What did they call this one? Get Shaken. Now, there's another version of this. Maybe one's British and one's American that has one different song. Whichever one you get, it's great. So on this album, he did a song called Revenue Man that goes back to George Jones' rockabilly era, right? And it's credited to Donnie Lytle, who you might know better as Johnny Paycheck, who actually played in George's band. Pretty wild, right? And so the Beatniks and I did it years ago, live, and then we put it out. It was unreleased, you know, it was a live recording. We unearthed all these previously unreleased recordings and released this album via the miracle of Landslide Records on this album called Powerful Stuff. And we do it about a million miles an hour on there, too. And it's a spot-on performance in hyperdrive. But, you know, that's what kids like, everything. So, you know, I never, with my guitar playing, I never spent a lot of time doing the flutter picking thing, so now I'm not good at it, and this song calls on me to do it. But, so I'm gonna do it. I've never done it in this tuning either. We'll see what happens. It's called Revenue Man.
Well, I was sent to a place down in North Carolina to pick up on a moonshine still. But when I got there, to my surprise, I could see a little light on the hill. Well, the people wasn't knowing, already I was showing that I was really hot to track. But if the NBC says it couldn't be me, well, I'll be the one to bring them back. Cause I'm a revenue man. Yes, I'm a revenue man. I got a badge on my pocket and a gun on my hip. Get them if I can. Well, the moon was shining bright as I looked across the river. I noticed on the side of the hill. Well, I could see a red light glowing really bright. I knew it had to be a still. Well, the people down the road said it wasn't far, but you ought to know someone. Cause if the moonshiners knew that I carried a star, you bet your bottom dollar that'll have them on the run. I'm a revenue man. Yes, I'm a revenue man. I got a badge on my pocket and a gun on my hip. I find moonshiners and a little bigger slip. Cause I'm a revenue man. I'll get them if I can.
Like screwing up the last lick of the song, right? It's supposed to be. I can't play it. Anyway, yep. I did rehearse it, folks. I'm sorry. Rhythm guitar is my forte, I think. So, okay. My apologies to the internet. We know you have choices when you cruise the interwebs, so we appreciate you being here with old Webb. Okay, now I'm going to try a whole nother thing I've never done before. Y'all probably don't appreciate being experimented on, do you? This song I always wanted to do, and it was always, you know, I've got, like, people say, that don't know me, they say, what's your band like? I said, well, it's kind of like Sleepy LaBeef singing with the Rolling Stones. I can't sing real high, you know. And so many people I grew up listening to did and do a lot of the songs I love. So this song, and then the cool guitar riffs are in those keys, right? So John Fogerty sings high. This is a great John Fogerty song. After Creedence. I'm not sure how many albums he made. He did the Creedence thing, made some solo stuff. The world didn't pay that much attention, sadly, because some great stuff. Then he had the big comeback, you know, with Center Field and all that. There's a song in here called Almost Saturday Night. And since it's Friday night, it's almost Saturday night. Country music the country music industry did a big tribute to Fogerty a while back, and he and Keith Urban did a pretty nice version of Almost Saturday Night, and I read an interview where Fogerty was like, you know, nobody ever did this song or something. Well, John, a lot of people did it. They just weren't hits. But Dave Edmunds did it, and I think the Searchers did it. Somewhere I've got, oh yeah, I've got the Searchers album that they tried to make a comeback with some good music, and no one noticed in the 80s. Rick Nelson did it. How about that? So it's a really cool song. And it's got a cool riff, and I think in Fogerty's key, it's here. But when it comes in, I can't hit the notes. So I was fooling around with it. We used to do it. And then my singing was too low, so. This past week, I figured out a different set of strings to play it on. See what you think. It's the great John Fogerty song, Almost Saturday Night. Well, I'm doing it again. Two, three, four. Saturday Night. It is a great song, and many people have done it. You know, Edmunds did a great version. He didn't even bother with the riff. I can't remember just how Rick Nelson did it, but God bless Rick Nelson. The first two albums I ever owned, one was by Rick Nelson and one was by Elvis Presley. Ordered them from Sears, yo. It's a cool thing. So, moving right along. We've got this new album, Night Without Love. And we have the CDs, you know, at webwildroot.com. We have the CD versions of all the albums there and all that. But this is the first time we've had a new album come out on vinyl in a long time. And kind of proud of that. So this is my visual aid, you know, for that. Another cool thing is that the song I'm about to tell you about, title cut, Night Without Love, kind of a comic book illustration of said title by the great artist Flournoy Holmes. That song is old, and we have a video for it, but the song was written by my old pal, R.S. Field, when I was in this band called The Drapes. A guy named Bruce Tennant sang it. Hi, Bruce, if you're listening. That's a lot of years ago, folks. The Drapes played their last gig in 1982, so get a grip on that. So, anyway, I always liked the song, and I wanted to do it, and I wound up whistling on it and stuff, you know. And to make a really long story short, my old buddy Dan Tyler's daughter, Elise Tyler, and her friend Abteen have done a fantastic video. And it'll be premiered on relics.com on Monday. So that's a cool thing, you know. And we'll be flooding all our anti-social media with it too, but it's going to start out there. And I was told I could make an announcement and everything, so. It's called Night Without Love. It's an old song, but it's new to the public, right? So it goes like this. I don't see how she can stand standing there against a man with a face like an idol from the Yucatan. What's he got that I haven't got? He's got her around the clock. What he's got that I haven't got is love. It's a sound in your heart down low. It's a beat that begins real slow. It's a boy and a girl real close, with plenty of time to know about the unlit fire and to know why a moonbed fool needs love, needs love, needs love. Love is illogical sometimes. It can wound, it can blind. Got a nice girl up on Tarzan's vine. I'm gonna die if I don't get it. How can you die when you're dead already? There ain't no light in the light that hasn't got love. It's a sound in your heart down low. It's a beat that begins real slow. It's a boy and a girl real close, with plenty of time to know about the unlit fire and to know why a moonbed fool needs love, needs love, needs love. I've been blanked by the unseen eye, been blanked by the question why. I spent too much time standing by, watching the worth watching girls pass by. I've seen God with them, I wonder how they got them. Have they tapped the link between the mother and the daughter? Have they seen a lamb smile through the slaughter? I've heard the drums that pound in the night. Have they heard the drums that pound in the night? I've heard the drums that pound in the night. I've heard the drums that pound overnight without love. Sound in your heart down low. It's a beat that begins real slow. It's a boy and a girl real close, with plenty of time to know about the unlit fire and to know why a moonbed fool needs love, needs love. I said it would premiere on relics.com, and I'll tell you why I said that in a minute. No, it's going to premiere Pop Matters. Go to their website, and with all apologies to both institutions, we really are excited about that. We really appreciate that. That'll be Monday. So I've let the cat out of the bag about another video I'm in, and it actually did premiere on relics.com today, so that was on my mind, and I'll get to that in a minute. Sorry about that, folks. So yeah, that's the song. I even made a note here and didn't read it. Okay, I was never good at homework and all that. I'm a big Nick Lowe fan. Again, the Rockpile poster's behind us. If you are yourself, check out Will Birch's biography, Cruel to Be Kind, same title as Nick's big hit of yesteryear. And he's got so many great songs, and I've always liked this one. I don't think I've ever done it anywhere. Maybe some sound checks on some solo gigs. It's from his album, The Impossible Bird, and it's kind of poking fun at entitlement. We're all so entitled, you know. It's called Where's My Everything? Where is the beautiful family home I was promised on the news at 10? Like my personal place in the sun, never happened alone. As for the greatest love of all, that's been told in a million lies, and is mine by birthright, of it I've seen none. Tell me where's my everything? Tell me where's my everything? Where are the children 2.3 that were meant to be sent to me? The patter of whose tiny feet make my life so sweet. They've been filed away with a pot of gold that was meant to cement my nest, while keeping out the cold and keeping in the rest. Tell me where's my everything? Tell me where's my everything? Where is the monument I'll leave to a grateful nation whose citizens time my tale is told? Tell me where's my everything? Where is the beautiful family home I was promised on the news at 10? I think about that sometimes when I'm wondering, you know, where are the free guitars in the mail or whatever, you know? Not that I get them or anything. I have my fantasies, of course. You know, this obviously was not a request-type show. However, one came in late in the day, and I was going through my notes and realized, you know, I'd never done it on any of these cyber shows from the basement. So I'm going to do it. And that will get me to the subject of relics.com, too. This is a song I wrote with Patrick Sweeney, who you should check out. He's a great artist, and John Hadley, who's a great songwriter. And Patrick and I have cameos in the new J.D. Simo video, which did premiere today on relics.com. It's a song called Love. So there's that to partially explain my dementia, you know. But this is on the Mississippi Modern album, and I started it with Patrick, and I finished it with John Hadley, and Patrick and I wanted to write something that was sort of like vibe, feel, groove, whatever, sort of like an old Joe Tex song, which we're both partial to, you know. And John definitely helped me finish it, but then I took it to the band, the Beatniks, and we were recording at a great old studio that has literally been reduced to rubble. It doesn't exist anymore. We're doing the Mississippi Modern album, and the guys, particularly Bob and Tom, came up with this great arrangement that's nothing like a Joe Tex song. So it's more like Creedence verses with Dave Edmunds choruses. But at any rate, I think it's something we can all relate to. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. It goes like this.
Now
got a side effect.
Self-promotion, I did mention Tom Comet. He's a fine young man. You know, he's a talented musician, but he has designed so many of the album covers and t-shirts and whatnot, who have you and what have you. We do have this beautiful new Night Without Love t-shirt. And I know what you're going to ask me, and here's the answer. Yes, the Webb Wilder credo is on the back. Work hard, rock hard, eat hard, sleep hard, grow big, wear glasses if you need them. I mean, look what it's done for me. There you go. No salesman will call. Just check red, green, or natural oak. Uh-huh. At some point, you know, it's funny. I still think in terms of, you know, vinyl and all that stuff and physical stuff, you know, with the records and all. And I still think in terms of sequencing and all that. So, going way back to... when is it, 95, we did the Town and Country album, which there's been some buzz about in the anti-social media world lately. The last song, it would have been on side B, but, you know, we didn't do vinyl on this album, which is sad. And this is back in print, by the way. The last song is actually the most streamed Webb Wilder song on Spotify. And we didn't know until recently, because we weren't playing it live for years or anything. It's called Rockin' Little Angel. And we got the song because of this album right here. Jerry Lee Lewis, Rockin' My Life Away. Wow. I mean, yes, arguably Jerry Lee's classic work was already behind him when he did this album, but wow. If you don't have this album, you just better get it. That's all I can say. You know, this album was done by, produced by a great producer who'd been around a while, Bones Howe, and... I mean, it's got Hal Blaine on drums, it's got James Burton, it's got great songs. And, I mean, some of these songs, you know, in fact, you know, I recorded Who Will the Next Fool Be, the old Silver Fox, Charlie Rich song. Jerry Lee did it on here. I think that had an effect on me wanting to do it later. The title cut was a Mac Vickery, almost nonsensical rocking thing called Rocking My Life Away. It was a hit. So, I mean, this was a real comeback for him, kind of like when Johnny Winter did the albums on Muddy Waters. So, anyway, you know, we did the Town and Country album. It's all covers. And we wanted to do Rockin' Little Angel. That's the song that's been spun the most on Spotify in the Webb Wilder catalog. Well, before Jerry Lee, it was another Sun artist named Rockin' Ray Smith. And one of y'all in the loving public had sent me some information that really somebody had done it before him. under maybe a slightly different title. So maybe Ray wasn't even the original artist. I don't know, but I'm gonna try to do it.
It's loud. It's loud. I can't hear you sing.
I'm gonna turn the guitar down. It's a little challenging doing electric guitar and acoustic vocals. I've got the little tiny amp way on the other side of the room.
But you know, Les Paul is a powerful instrument. There's that to consider, you know.
So, it goes like.
I'm your little angel, come down from the sky, down from the sky.
Album some when I gave you the backstory on Revenue Man, and powerful stuff. You know, in the early days of the band, R.S. Field, or Bobby Field as I call him, he's the original drummer, so he's like the principal songwriter in the band. He left the band and he produced the band, so we were always eager to get the next Bobby Field song, you know, and so he brought this song that I'm about to do to us. We said, that's great. He had a demo, we worked up his demo, we started playing it, we were getting ready to record it, not realizing that his co-writers had publishers too, and they were pitching it. And there's legendary story that there's an unreleased Motley Crue version of this song, which is hard to believe. What wound up happening, but it's probably true, what wound up happening is that the Fabulous Thunderbirds did it. And of course, I'm a big fan, you know, so that was cool, but we immediately thought, we better stop doing this song or people think we're covering the radio. So we always did covers, but not the hits of the day, you know. And so it was Shell forever. And when we were doing the research, George Bradfute and I were going through the vaults, so to speak. We found this great live version we'd recorded at Mountain Stage, and Landslide wanted to use it as the title cut of the album, and the rest is kind of history, so we put it out. It's called Powerful Stuff. You don't have to do it. If you do, it's deeply appreciated. In the meantime, in between time, this is Webb Wilder saying have a wonderful weekend.